Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm your host as always, Steve Hall, and we are going to summarize episode 109 with Ryan Doris. It was a fantastic episode. Let's get into the summary points. The first summary point is that success can often be boring. Sometimes the tasks that we have to do daily to get to our goals are monotonous. It means doing the same things day in, day out. Bodybuilding, for example. What we need to do is lift with intent and look to progress our lifting over time and make it harder and harder. Now, there's various exercises we can use, there's various repetition ranges we can use and programming variables, but the actual meat and potatoes training and the meat and potatoes nutrition is quite boring. There isn't some magical way of making it more exciting. It is what it is. And when you're a businessman trying to promote and get more money, often the daily tasks that have to be done are the ones that can promote the most success. So that's summary point number one. Summary point number two is to become a better person of yourself. It's important to have some foundational things within your day already and within your person. So for example, you might need a nutrition plan and know that you're going to eat certain meals at certain times and get that done to then put more energy towards other areas of your life. Or for example, a quote I really like is to be selfish can help you be selfless, because if you can get some things that mean a lot to you done in the day, for example, your training, then you can focus more of your attention to other things later and be mindful of those. Whereas if you are always thinking when you're with other people, oh, I wish I'd done my training, then you're never truly going to be with those other people. So it's important to have some foundational things to get right within yourself before then you can give more to other areas of your life. Kind of like Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Summary point number three is one of the harshest ways that we punish people is to put them in isolation. You put them in a prison cell on their own. There's no one they can talk to. There's no one they can communicate with. It's very, very isolating, horrible. It's really not a nice punishment. You'd think there's worse ways to punish people, but isolation is one of the most severe. This is why when we are a bodybuilder or a physique competitor, we're going to stage, it's important to have loved ones close. It's important to keep those relationships healthy, because if you let them all go to absolute poop, then you're going to isolate yourself and not be in a good situation. You are putting yourself under one of the worst forms of punishment. Summary point number four is that self-sabotage is really easy, because we process fear sooner than we process logic. It's just part of being a human being. We might do something as a knee-jerk reaction and actually cause ourselves more harm than good because we're fearful of things. So it's important to take a couple of breaths, to take a step back, to be logical about things, keep perspective, and then move forward. Because sometimes that action of fear can create self-sabotage where we cause a lot of problems. An example might be that there's some cookies out on the counter, and so we just grab it and we eat it because we're hungry, we're on a diet, and it's tasty food. But that's self-sabotage. That's going to create more calories within your diet. You may not be able to rectify that later in the day. And so we need to have an ability to either remove such issues, such as having the cookies away, or the ability to take a few seconds, take a breath, be logical about things. The fifth and final point is that sometimes when we need to push ourselves to extremes, we need to work loads of hours during the day to get the work done for our business. We need to go to extreme levels of body fat for our physique competition. We have to stay up overnight because maybe our son or daughter's ill. You just have to almost go dumb. You have to go to a place that you shouldn't normally go. You have to push yourself to your limits. And sometimes the best athletes, the most extreme sports, people take themselves to places they probably shouldn't. And you have to, as a physique competitor, a male or female bodybuilder, where conditioning and lean levels of body mass, body fat, are very, very important, you have to go dumb. You have to do something that's actually stupid. You take yourself to an unhealthy place. Sometimes that's required to get to where you really want to go. Our favorite quote from today's podcast is that self-sabotage never sleeps. So you might think you have everything under control. You might think you have your shit together. But remember, your fear, that self-sabotage, could come out of nowhere. So always keep it within your mind. Always remember, take those deep breaths. Take a moment. Keep perspective, because every single day, self-sabotage could get you. So guys, I hope you've enjoyed the summary of this podcast. It was quite a unique podcast with Ryan Doris. Please let us know what your feedback is. Give us a thumbs up if you like this. Give us a share. Give us a subscribe if you haven't already. As always, take a picture of me with my thumbs up on your Instagram. We love seeing you guys share our content there. And we will see you soon. Revive stronger.